To determine the proper size, two measurements are required. The distance from the sacrococcygeal junction to the scapular spine and the circumferential measurement around the umbilicus or waist. To prepare the orthosis for application, open the flap on the posterior panel. Using the tool provided or other 1/8 inch hex tool, ensure that all adjustment screws on the noble hinge posterior panel are slightly loosened and in the disengaged position. Remove one side of the side closure attachment from the anterior panel. Loosen both of the shoulder straps. Patient should be standing for product application. Insert arms through the shoulder straps, one arm at a time, similar to a backpack or jacket application. Secure the side closure attachment by applying the strip to the anterior panel. At each side of the orthosis, the patient will find dynamic pull straps. Instruct the patient to pull each strap forward at the same time to tighten the brace evenly and to prevent any torque to the lumbar spine. Once a comfortable level of compression is achieved, secure the pull straps on the anterior panel of the orthosis. To ensure proper placement, the anterior panel should sit directly above the symphysis pubis. The posterior panel should sit directly above the sacrococcygeal junction and extend to the scapular spine. Readjust as needed. Instruct the patient to tighten the shoulder straps by grabbing the D-rings at their shoulders and pulling forward and down. Once a comfortable amount of compression is achieved, secure the straps on the shoulder pads. To make the proper adjustments to the noble hinge, position the patient into a prone position on the fitting table. Open the posterior flap to expose the noble hinge. Apply slight pressure to the hinge in the lumbar region to ensure the hinge follows the patient's spinal curvature. Using the hex tool, tighten the adjustment screws in the lumbar region. Continue following the curvature of the spine over the thoracic region, tightening the adjustment screws on both sides until you reach the top. A preload can also be achieved by leaving a 1/2 to 1 inch gap between the patient and the posterior panel from the apex of the kyphotic angle and above. This is achieved by placing a hand under the top of the orthosis while tightening the adjustment screws in this region. Once the orthosis has been locked into the correct position, close the posterior flap and assist the patient into a supine position with their knees comfortably bent or flexed and their hips parallel to their shoulders. Ensure that the anterior panel is in the correct position, then have the patient repeat the strap tightening procedure for the side closures and shoulder straps. Assist the patient into a standing position and check for a proper fit. For additional support and comfort, the preformed flexible panel can be added to the posterior panel. While the patient is not wearing the orthosis, align the flexible panel flush to the bottom edge of the posterior panel and centered. Place the two pieces of hook around the frame of the posterior panel and attach to the posterior flap to secure. reapply the orthosis to the patient and check for a proper fit. An additional strapping configuration can be obtained by switching out the Y-tabs on the shoulder straps with the provided D-ring Y-tab. The patient can then tighten the shoulder straps from the lower portion by grabbing the D-rings and pulling the straps down and forward and attaching them on the anterior panel. If the patient feels any discomfort under their arms from the shoulder strapping, the lower attachment point of the shoulder straps can also be adjusted. Choose one of the three positions for the most appropriate fit. Loosen the screw and move the components to the desired location and retighten screw. Repeat on the opposite side.